من فانظر إلى طعامك وشرابك لم يتسنه وانظر إلى حمارك ولنجعلك آية للناس وانظر إلى العظام كيف ننشزها ثم نكسوها لحما فلما تبين له قال أعلم أن الله على كل شيء قدير. The second form of resurrection. أو كالذي مر على قرية. اختلفوا في هذا في من المار. The علماء here, some say it was Yusha ibn Nun, some say it was Azair, and some say it was Khidr radiallahu anhu. So whoever it is, that is not of our concern. Like one day, we had a very heated argument about Musa alayhi salam and the two sisters that he married. And people say that it was Shuaib alayhi salam's daughters. So there's a heated argument that there's nothing to show that it was Shuaib's daughters. So I just asked my sheikh and said, whether it was Shuaib's daughters or not, what difference does it make? Does marrying Shuaib's daughter make Musa a better prophet? Or not marrying Shuaib's daughter make him a lesser prophet? Is it min ahkamatuddin? So sometimes we argue over things that are not beneficial. So whether it was Khidr or Uzair or Yusha ibn Nun, we are not concerned with that. We want to know the basis of the story. Why did Allah mention it here? There was a person going through, he was traveling through a city outside the outskirts of the city, and he found the ruins of a city, and he did not question it, but he started asking himself, how will this city be revived? There's nothing wrong with asking. It is not that you're questioning Allah's authority, but you sometimes ask yourself, is it possible? How will Allah revive this? We'll see in the third ayah how Ibrahim alayhi salam also questioned himself. So what Allah did, Allah took away his life and revived him after 100 years. And then he asked him, how long do you think you've been sleeping here? He put him into a deep slumber of 100 years. And in 100 years, the city's structure and infrastructure changes. If I came back here after 100 years, I might not be able to find Masjid Rahmah. Why? Because Masjid Rahmah might have changed. The landscapes have changed. So he asked him, how long have you been here? He said, a day or two. He said, no. انظر إلى طعامك وشرابك لم يتسنى. Look at your food and your drink. Food and drink gets decayed and spoiled in a day. It does not stay without refrigeration for more than a day. She said, look at your food and drink. It is intact. So that means it's not a day or two. So it means it was less than a day or two. He said, no, look at your donkey. It is decayed. The bones are no more. You can just see the spine. So he wanted to remove the doubt that it is less than a day. Why? Because the donkey has decayed, and you have to show him it's 100 years, but the food and drink are still intact, fresh. And now I want to bring out something most people will be amazed with. In Kitab al-Hayawanat, the most intelligent animal after humans on the face of earth is a donkey. We call the donkey stupid. But the most intelligent animal on the face of earth after humans is a donkey. There has been no recording of a donkey giving birth to date. If it feels any human presence in and the child is out, only the hind legs are in, it will pull it back in. It is that intelligent and sensitive. If a donkey steps here, 50 years later, it will still step on the same footstep. You have never seen a donkey fall off a mountain. In Lamu, the donkeys are not herded by anyone. They leave in the morning, They do their jobs, go to the field, graze and come back at exact time. If you follow the footsteps, they will put their footstep in the exact same location. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is using the donkey. He wants to prove to you something. In Kitab al-Hayanat it is written that this person after 100 years still found his way home. After 100 years he still found his way home because of the donkey. The donkey still remembered its footsteps. But why is the donkey called stupid? Inshallah, in our next darsa, I will let you know. Subhanakallahu bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Nastaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Sallallahu ala khayri khalqi Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.